The performances so far have been really good, different. They've been varying and different, and it depends on the audience. It just depends on the energy of the audience, and that's about it. So if you come to me and you as a collective audience are enthusiastic and you know what you're getting and you're getting the real thing, I'm going to give you everything. Your performance has been amazing. Big and black and dark and gashy and just the way Beinhorn produces just massive. And so the records that, you know, I look to for this record is Diamond Dogs, definitely, and The Wall by Pink Floyd, because The Wall was so big, 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 big. And Diamond Dogs wasn't as big, but Diamond Dogs was incredibly ambitious, very Bowie. So if you don't know what those records are, you probably shouldn't. Other than Le Disastre, which is America's Sweetheart, which was supposed to be ha-ha-ha funny, but it was just a bad joke, I've always done good titles. I have had Pretty on the Inside, My Body the Hand Grenade, Celebrity Skin. I'm big on titles. Titles have to be just perfect. I'm very, very specific with words and the English language. It matters to me. Grammar matters to me, although I don't have perfect grammar because I'm an autodidact. So an autodidact, that means I went to school by myself. Words matter to me, and so I don't feel like I'm anyone's daughter. I feel adrift. I feel abandoned and an orphan. I feel like my daughter might not feel like anyone's daughter, or she's obviously two people's daughter that are very prominent. In a strange way, even though I don't like my mother and I'm estranged from her very much, she wasn't anyone's daughter either. And her mother, my grandmother Paula, wasn't anyone's daughter either. Paula grew up in the Hollywood orphanage. My mother was adopted from Paula. I don't even know who my grandfather is. He's either a little publicist who was 5'4" or a big old movie star who was this fat. I have no idea. It's one of the two guys. And my matrilineage is so fouled up. And then my patrilineage, or whatever it is also very fouled up. So, you know, between me and Francis, we don't have a lot of family. I'm a pure musician. What music does for me is puts me in a better mood. I would much rather depend on my guitar than some dude. That's always going to be the case. So music empowers me. It gives me, by playing music, I am the boss of me. And you know, little kids always say, you're not the boss of me. I love that phrase. You're not the boss of me. I remember Francis was before, you're not the boss of me. I say it all the time, because no one's really the boss of me. I'm my own boss. And the reason I'm my own boss is because I can tune my own guitar, play my own guitar, and make my own songs, and you can't take that away from me. Now, having said that, when you act, you're involved with hundreds and hundreds of other people. You have to get, you know, you have to be on a list. You have to hope and pray you get a part. You have to get, then when you get the part, you have to like hope and pray you get the right director who knows how to handle you. And it's wonderful when it works. And I've only had two experiences with Milos Forman that worked. The other ones were like, I didn't pick so well, whatever. But I really do like acting a lot, and I'm really good at it if I'm well directed. I'm definitely a second banana in that situation, because my crazy is much stronger when it comes to... I was watching Sherlock Holmes last night with Downey in it, and he's so amazing in it. He's so amazing. I'm so happy for him. He's so fortunate he gets to come back and be better than he ever was after what he went through. But in the case of acting, I mean, you just got to get your crazy on the same way you do with rock and roll. It's, as I said before, people have this fantasy about rock and roll that we're not respectable, that we're not just as... respectable as a fine artist or as an actor or as, you know, someone with a, you know, quote, normal, interesting job. I'm empowered for my job. That doesn't mean I am my job. You know, one of the worst parts of my job is when I get off stage and I'm too amped up and this stuff is seeped into me. I don't like that. And I'm trying to, I'm 45. And again, you can just call this my midlife crisis, and I hope you enjoy it, because I don't think I'm going to be doing it forever. It's a limited edition kind of thing. I am most looking forward to, with this album cycle, I've made the damn thing. I love it. You can't take that away from me. I'm most looking forward to finding my identity as a relevant rock musician today and as a dignified rock musician today. I'm not in any way a dishonorable person, so my honor matters to me more than probably anything else. I'm looking forward to, you know, I look to people like, I don't know, Chris Martin, Bono, Michael Stipe, and I look at how honorably they do their jobs, and I'm always going to be a little bit bawdier and a little more Mae West, and I guess I'm always going to grab my crotch a little bit. So the New York Times described me as incorrigible. I've been being described as incorrigible since I was two. There's nothing new there. So I'm always going to be a little incorrigible, but I am definitely happy to be in a band that supports me. I want a better infrastructure to tour. There's no way I can continue to tour without a good infrastructure. It's not going to happen. I'm looking forward to not having to make decisions about whether I want the lingerie or the linens. I want both. The good linens and the good lingerie. That's me. No, I don't think that women make great rock stars. You know why? Because I'm the only one. So, no, I'm not the only woman rock star, but I'm the only one from my generation that's still standing. I think that women have a hard time with exactly what I'm having a hard time with, which is, what am I as a woman? You're a woman, and so you can have babies. And be, I don't know if you know that, kids, but you can have babies if you're a woman, and you can't have the baby if you're a boy. So, there is definitely a toughness that you have to grow around you, but in order to keep your femininity intact and be, you know, utterly vulnerable, which is what I am as a musician, you also have to be super tough. And I'm not a guy. I'm not a control freak. I don't even date people that are like under 40. I'm 45. That would just be gross to me. I'm not judging anyone else. I'm just saying, as rock stars, you know, men, like, they get driven off the sex of it. Very different from women. And when me and Melissa Oftermar was in the band, we once had this experiment in Cleveland, of course, where we tried to make out with these two guys, and I, of course, picked the blonde who lost all his hair next tour around and brought his mother. And Melissa picked a much cuter brunette. Anyway, we made out with these boys, and it was just gross. Because the boys got the story, not the girls. We didn't really have the story. We had nothing to be proud of, other than we'd been kind of slutty. But then the dudes were like, yeah, hey, hey. So, I mean, you can't change that physiological reality, and you can't change natural selection. And natural selection is just a fact. And it means that it's gender neutral in the sense that possessiveness is on both sides of it, but also extracurricular activities are on both sides of it. So you've got to, I'm not talking about relationships here, but I'm talking about how you've got to not be a jealous person. You've got to try and not be a jealous person. And then you can have something like a relationship-ish thing, I don't know. But I sure as hell hope so. I don't know. We'll see. It's a social experiment. So, in fact, I think the next generation of girls will make good rock stars. I think most of the girls that should have been rock stars in this generation became snowboarders.